Can you treat anxiety with electric shocks? Can you treat anxiety with electric shocks? Well, you probably might say, no, it makes it even worse. I mean, if you get an electric shock, you probably develop more aversive feelings. So it is quite strange to see that in one study published in 1977 by Irving Kirsch and David Henry, the scientists tried to treat anxiety with electric shocks, and they told the participants, well, you tell us some situations in which you feel anxiety, and then you try to relive these situations, or you imagine these situations, and whenever the anxiety is very strong, you get an electric shock in order to punish your anxiety reaction. And if we punish your anxiety reaction, it probably won't come again. And well, you could argue that this sounds plausible, but other scientists would say this is complete bullshit, because in many experiments it was shown that by giving electric shocks, usually aversive reactions and anxiety are created. So now you want to delete anxiety with electric shocks. This is quite strange. But what were the results? It turned out that this therapy method was almost equally effective as systematic desensitization, which is that whenever you imagine a anxiety-provoking situation, you try to relax, for example, via progressive muscle relaxation by Jacobson. So how on earth is it possible that two completely opposite treatments have the same result, that in both conditions anxiety goes down? Well, the scientists suppose that in fact placebo effects play a very important role, and this is actually something that could be shown in the study, that the more plausible the treatment was seen by the patients, the more effective the treatment was. So human beings are much more than stimulus response robots, which you can condition the way you want. It's very important what people think what's happening with a stimulus. If they think the stimulus, for example an electric shock, will delete their anxiety, this electric shock can in fact have somewhat this effect. And this is really, really interesting. And another reason why electric shocks was almost equally effective as systematic desensitization is that in fact systematic desensitization, and we know that today, is not really effective in treating social phobia. So you probably also only get a placebo effect in this treatment. What's much more effective is, for example, metacognitive therapy, in which it's all about where you focus your attention. For example, if you give a speech, for example, when I'm talking to you right now, in earlier days, I was much more focused on how I am presenting myself. I thought, well, how do I have to hold my hands? How do I have to look right now? And all this self-consciousness cripples your performance, and in the end it's like a vicious circle. You think, well, I was performing really bad, and the only reason was because I had no cognitive resources left over, because I was so focused on myself instead of focusing on the content. And this is what you learn in metacognitive therapy. For example, if you talk to a stranger on the street, you are not focused on how am I looking at the moment. For example, you focus on how is he looking. For example, you focus on what he's actually telling you, and you try to listen, and you try everything to get out of your head. And this is up to date and probably the most effective therapy method to treat social phobia. So that's it for today. Keep in mind that human beings are much more than stimulus response robots, and it's very important what people believe what is effective, and what they are told what is effective.